Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby, and this time let's get an update on Saturday, April the 20th, some workout news from the last couple of days, and we'll also take a look at Track Phantom going into the Kentucky Derby, how he got there, and some trip notes from the Track Phantom races. Starting off with the leaderboard update, no change or word on the official Derby starters the last couple of days. We've still got some jockeys to be determined for the Derby and the Oaks. And on deck right now, Encino, a decision to be made if he is going to be running in the Derby. You've got Granmo the First and Common Defense for trainer Ken McPeak. Now, works out ready the last couple of days. We had a work team in tandem on Thursday. Just FYI, of course, she raced in the Ashland Stakes for her only 2024 start. She's going in the Kentucky Oaks, 4 furlongs in company with Resilience. Resilience galloped out a little bit better of those two horses. He is going into the Kentucky Derby, and they worked on Thursday. On Friday, we had Fierceness. This was really his big move to get ready for the Derby. 5/8 of a mile, 1 35/100 seconds. He galloped out 6 furlongs and 113. Johnny V flew in to work him out over the Gulfstream Park surface, and basically Fierceness now, he's gonna have one more work that may be at Churchill Downs next Friday, or it could be at Gulfstream before shipping up. So we'll find that out next week, but all systems go for Fierceness. Now, 15 horses are on the grounds. Fierceness still in Florida. Granmo the First still in Florida. T.O. Password is in Japan. And jockeys still to be officially announced. Resilience, most likely it's going to be Junior Alvarado, who rode him, rides a lot for Belmont, but Johnny V rode him in the Wood Memorial. You've got Honor Marie, no official word yet, Society Man, and Catalytic still to be determined for jockeys for the Derby. Now, Catalytic did have a 5 furlong workout on Friday in just a little over 1 flat. Track Phantom getting ready for the Kentucky Derby. No official works this week. Of course, he ran 4th in the Louisiana Derby. Let's take a look at his past performances. He's one of the few horses with 3 lifetime wins. He picked up a maiden win at Churchill Downs by 4. Then he won the Gunrunner Stakes and the LeCompte Stakes. All 7 of his career races, he's either been on the lead or within a half a length at the stretch call. And a lot of those races, he was on the lead at the second call. So Track Phantom brings some speed to the race. Let's take a look at his maiden special weight race. He also won the Gunrunner and the LeCompte, a 3-time winner. Let's go back to his debut. He was 3rd on October 1st. Then on October 29th, he's leading into the stretch. He gets run down by Real Men Violin. And Real Men Violin picked up a nice win in the slop that day. Track Phantom showed his speed, took a lead into the stretch, just couldn't hold off Real Men Violin. So Track Phantom didn't like the sloppy track, I don't think, that day. Kind of stuck on the rail, lost that lead late, but it was a good performance. Then he goes first place finish on November 25th, Stars of Tomorrow card. He led at the half mile pole, draws off by 4 lengths. Joel Rosario is the jockey, but Track Phantom showing his speed, getting loose down the stretch, impressive victory at Churchill Downs. Now, he did show speed in that race, and he drew off for a big win. Always nice to see a 3- or 4-length win if you can get it in those maiden races. It does show a little bit of class. Track Phantom then goes down to the fairgrounds, and he picks up a win in the Gunrunner. He defeated Nash. Track Phantom came into that race as a second favorite, pressed the pace early, took a little bit of heat, then drew off on the turn, held off the closers in the lane. Track Phantom was straight down the stretch, fast track, and that was his 4th race of 2023. He got a little bit of a bottom underneath him, got some experience as a 2-year-old. Then as a 3-year-old, he comes out in the LeCompte Stakes, and he's kind of bet down, shows speed from an outside post position, led into the stretch, and then was run down, tried to get run down late, but held on for the victory in that LeCompte Stakes. So that was his 3rd straight win, a maiden win, the Gunrunner win, the LeCompte win, Track Phantom with 3 wins in a row. He goes in as one of the main contenders in And really, he had shown some good speed, but his pace ratings, 89 early in the LeCompte, 89 late, and Joel Rosario rode him again in that LeCompte. Now, in the Risen Star, a little bit different scenario, a little bit more speed, bigger field. He ran an 89 early pace, a 92 late pace, so he actually picked it up, but he was run down by Sierra Leone. That was a sloppy track. Overall, Track Phantom, what I like about him, he's got those even early pace and late pace ratings, so he's not as one-dimensional speedball as he looks in the past performances. Overall, for Track Phantom, 7 races. He's shown speed in all of them. His running style is early. We did do a video on the running styles if you want to watch that on Friday. And he does have a win at Churchill Downs. And he's been in some key races with some strong horses like Stronghold, Sierra Leone in that Risen Star race, which ended up being a productive race. Meanwhile, the biggest questions on Track Phantom, 10 furlongs. He's kind of been holding steady on his buyer speed figures. And will it be a faster pace in the Kentucky Derby? Now, they're contemplating putting some blinkers on for the Kentucky Derby, but that is not official yet, and he just doesn't seem to be improving. So that's the projected odds for Track Phantom. And when you look at all the projected odds on the race, Circa has come out with some odds on the Derby. Fierceness now the favorite, Sierra Leone 3.5 to 1, Catching Freedom at 9 to 1. It looks like Track Phantom could be right around 20 to 1 on Derby Day with the odds. Of course, we got post positions coming now, just a week away, April 27th, the Derby Pedigree Show on April 29th, the Derby Handicapping Show on April 30th, and the Triple Crown Prospectus comes out every week. We are going to be taking a look this week at some of the rankings of the top 20 horses. We take a look at the Oaks contenders, and we're going to go a little bit more in depth on the running styles. Still time to sign up comes out January through the Belmont Stakes, 2,000 words every week. Then the Pedigree Show is coming up on April 29th. Jessica Tugwell of Hawkstone Bloodstock going to join me. We're going to talk about all of the contenders, go over every race, talk about how she looks at female families, and kind of some of the microbiota DNA that she looks at for the contenders to see which ones. She also looks at some nicking patterns and emerging sires. Of course, she goes to the sales and she does some pedigree analysis work for some owners. If you haven't caught up this week, we've got a speed figure top contender video. We've also got a historical prep race analysis. We look at which prep races have produced the most Kentucky Derby winners, and then also the running styles of the contenders came out on Friday. I like going over that kind of just to see where horses prefer to run. And the Saturday notebook, we're going to have a tip sheet for the Derby, the Preakness, and the Belmont. Sign up below in the description. We're getting closer, just a couple of weeks out now from the Kentucky Derby, a week away from post positions. What are you leaning on Track Phantom? Do you think he can add some pace to the race? Also, running styles of the top contenders, leave a comment. And if you have a video you want to see on a topic, we've got some more things coming up this week. We're going to take a look at the final fractions and some other theories on the Derby as we get you ready for 2024. Remember, Dwayne Lucas says people have opinions, horses have the facts.